It's an amazing feeling. You're going through and it's dark and all of a sudden I could see fish and then I could see this mountain. And I have no doubt that I was one of the first people ever to see that space. I'm Bart Shepard. I'm director of Steinhart Aquarium at the California Academy of Sciences. We have this great stage where we bring people in and we showcase the biodiversity and the wonderful things that are found on our planet. A big part of my job is the care and the feeding and the management of the living collection here at the Academy. But another really exciting part of my job is exploration diving. The Philippines is a special place. This latest expedition was really to document the biodiversity in an area that's known as the Verde Island Passage. It seems to be the place that has more species in the ocean than anywhere else on Earth. This was a huge expedition. I think we topped out at nearly 70 participants, and not all of those are Academy scientists. We also had Filipino professors, collaborators, students, educators, a wide range of people representing different functions and different disciplines. One of the things that made this trip different and more exciting was that we were doing exploration in what we call the Twilight Zone, or mesophotic coral reefs, which are found typically below the depths that you would normally see recreational scuba diving, anywhere from 250 to say 500 feet. So this area has been largely unexplored. About half of what we see is unknown to science. In order to reach these areas, we're using a technology that's known as closed circuit rebreathers. We also breathe very specialized gas. So we're diving with Trimix, which is a mix of oxygen, nitrogen, and helium, so that you don't get the narcosis. We're really breathing something that's on the order of about 70% helium. So the really fun part about that is the helium voice when you're talking to each other at 300 feet. It's really exciting for me to be a part of one of these teams that's starting to do some of this exploration, and at a time when it's so critical, understanding what's going on with the health of our oceans.